Hi, and welcome to the Change History Google Ads API Developer Series. My name is Sasha, and I'll be your host. This is episode 1 in a 6-episode series that'll continue into 2022. I'll be covering the Change History feature in the Google Ads API. The series won't be useful to you unless you're already familiar with the Google Ads API and with the Google Ads query language. So if that describes you, there are some links in the video description that will help. All right, here's what you can expect from today's video. I'll talk about the two components of the Change History feature in a tale of two API services. Then I'll describe the request structure, and then wrap up this episode with practical limitations. All right, a tale of two API services. So we've got two, you know what, actually, I think this is gonna be easier if you follow me over here. Okay, come over here. So Change History consists of two API services. The change status service and the change event service. These two services offer very different perspectives on the same underlying data. So change status exposes an aggregate summary of changes, whereas change event exposes each change individually. So one way I like to think about these two services and disambiguate between them is change status answers the question of did this change, whereas change event answers the question of how did this change. Okay, let's go back to the slides. So as I said, change status offers aggregate summaries, while change event exposes each change individually. Both of these services operate over a specific window of time that you must specify for each request. And speaking of requests, request structure. Each request will use either the search or search stream methods, which are available in our client libraries or over REST. You'll also need a customer ID for each request. Then the query, which is a Google Ads query language string. For change history data, you'll specify change event or change status in the from clause. Both services have extra Google Ads query language requirements, namely the where and limit clause. I'll get into the details of these requirements in a later video. And that brings us to the last topic for today's video, caveats and limitations. Both the change status service and change event service have some limits that will affect how you use them. For change status, you will only have access to 90 days of data, and for change event, 30 days. Then, for both services, there is a maximum of 10,000 rows per request. In addition to that, the request must explicitly include closed date windows, that is, the where requirement that I mentioned earlier. And as I said before, requests must include a limit, which has a maximum of 10,000. There's a couple more things to consider. Only some resources are supported by change history at this time. For specifics, check out the video description. And then, not all clients generate change events. The big one is the AdWords API, which won't generate change events, but will still appear in change status. So keep these things in mind for next time while I'll talk about change status and we explore the last change date time field. That's it for today. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe.